Hello everyone. Today we are going to start with lecture number 1 of power electronics subject. The topic of today's session is SCR, silicon control rectifier. This topic belongs to unit number 1. Name of the unit is power devices. This subject, power electronics, belongs to third year ENTC of Savitribai Phule Pune University. In today's lecture, we are going to see course outcome, introduction about the subject, introduction about SCR, operating modes, characteristics, two transistor analogy of SCR, gate drive circuit, SCR ratings, opto isolator circuit, series and parallel operation, and SCR as a switch. Myself, Professor Amit Kumar Mishra, I am having total 10 years of teaching experience, and my domain expertise is of 10 years. Let's start with the course outcome. At the end of this course, students should be able to design and implement a triggering gate drive circuit for a power device, understand, perform, and analyze different controlled converters. Second course outcome. At the end of the course, students should be able to evaluate battery backup time and design a battery charger. And third course outcome. Students should be able to design and implement over voltage, over current protection circuit. Introduction. First of all, what is electronics? It's a branch of engineering deals with the flow of electron through gas, vacuum, or semiconductor. What is power electronics? It is technology associated with efficient conversion and control of electrical power using power semiconductor devices. Efficient conditioning or processing and control of electrical power by using power semiconductor devices in order to supply high quality power to the loading, causing minimum pollution of environment and utility supply circuit. Types of power converters. Converters are of 5 types: rectifier, inverter, chopper, cycloconverter, AC voltage controller. Let's see what is rectifier. So rectifier is a power converter that converts AC at constant voltage frequency to DC at variable voltage. Basically, it converts AC to DC. What is inverter? Inverter is a power converter that converts DC at constant voltage to AC at desired voltage and frequency. So basically, it converts DC to AC. Third is chopper. Chopper is a power converter that converts DC at constant voltage to DC at desired voltage. So it's a DC to DC converter. Fourth, cycloconverter. Cycloconverter is a power converter that converts AC at constant voltage and frequency to AC at desired voltage and frequency. The last is AC voltage controller. AC voltage controller is a power electronic device that converts AC at constant voltage and frequency to AC at desired voltage and input frequency. Basically, it's an AC to AC converter. Let's start with the first topic of this unit. The name of this topic is silicon controlled rectifier. Silicon controlled rectifier or semiconductor controlled rectifier is a 4-layer solid state device that controls the current flow. The name silicon controlled rectifier is a trade name for the type of thyristor commercialized at General Electric in 1957. An SCR can be seen as a conventional rectifier controlled by a gate signal. It is a 4-layered, 3-junction and 3-terminal device. When the gate to cathode voltage exceeds a certain threshold, the device turns on and conducts current. Silicon controlled rectifier. This is the structure of that. So just we have seen there are 4 layers in that. So those layers are P positive, N negative, P and N positive. What is P positive? It's highly doped. Density is around 10 raised to power 18 per centimeter cube. What is N negative? N negative means it is lightly doped with the electron. So 10 raised to power 14 per centimeter cube. P means moderately doped. that is 10 raised to power 17 per centimeter cube. This is the symbol of SCR. It consists of three terminals, anode, cathode and gate. Device is made up of silicon because leakage current in silicon is very small as compared to germanium. Since the device is used as a switch, it will carry leakage current in the off condition, which should be as small as possible. It got this name because it is a silicon device and is used as a rectifier, and that rectification can be controlled. Let's see the SCR operating modes. SCR operation has four states. First is forward blocking mode. Second is reverse blocking mode. Third is forward conduction mode without gate signal. And last is forward conduction mode with gate signal. What is forward blocking mode? So this is the structure of SCR. It consists of three junctions, J1, J2 and J3. In forward blocking mode, we give supply of positive DC voltage between anode and cathode. So positive terminal of the battery is getting connected with the P layer of the SCR of junction J1, and negative terminal of the battery is getting connected with the N layer of junction J3 of SCR. So what happened is J1 and J3 is forward biased, and for J2, N is connected with the positive terminal of the battery and P is connected with the negative terminal of the battery. Therefore, J2 is reverse biased. So two junctions, J1 and J3 is forward biased, so it will allow the flow of current, and J2 is reverse biased, so it won't allow the flow of current. So device will remain in blocking mode. So this is called as forward blocking mode. Second operating mode is reverse blocking mode. Now what is this reverse blocking mode? So we are going to give negative supply or reverse supply between anode and cathode. So negative terminal of the battery is getting connected with the P of the J1 junction, and positive terminal of the battery is getting connected with the N of the junction J3. So J1 and J3 will be reverse biased. Now J2. So for J2, N is connected with the negative terminal and P is connected with the positive terminal of the battery. Therefore, J2 is forward biased. So J2 will allow the flow of current. J1 and J3 won't allow the flow of current. Therefore, device will remain in blocking mode. And this is called as reverse blocking mode of SCR. Third is forward conduction mode without gate signal. Now again, we are going to give the forward voltage between anode and cathode. What will happen? J1, J3 forward biased, J2 reverse biased. Now this J2 won't allow the flow of current. Therefore, there is some barrier exist over here due to which it doesn't allow the flow of carrier across it. Assume that the width of that barrier is W. So this W is inversely proportional to the applied voltage, VAK. Therefore, as we increase this VAK, that W will reduce. And once this VAK becomes greater than VBO, that is forward breakover voltage, then this barrier will get vanish. And hence, carrier can move across junction J2. Now what will happen is, initially, J1 and J3 was allowing the flow of current. Now, J2 can also allow the flow of current. Last is forward conduction mode with gate signal. SCR consists of third terminal, which is gate. And it is very essential to provide the supply across the gate terminal. Now, what happened is, once we are giving the gate DC voltage between across the gate terminal, it will produce the gate current. Every device, every SCR is made to trigger at particular gate current. Once that device will get that amount of gate current, the device will get triggered and hence it will get on. Let's see VI characteristic of SCR. This VI characteristic of SCR has been plotted between anode current versus anode voltage. This anode voltage is voltage between anode and cathode. That means, if we are increasing voltage between anode and cathode, then what is the effect on the circuit current? So we'll see this according to its operating mode. In first mode, we have forward biased the device. Therefore, J1 and J3 is forward biased, J2 is reverse biased. So main current won't flow. There will be only small current through the circuit. So that has been shown over with this. Now in second mode, which is reverse blocking mode, we are given negative voltage between anode and cathode. So what will happen? J1 and J3 reverse biased, J2 is forward biased. So what will happen is, again device will not conduct, only minority carrier will flow. And as we have given the reverse voltage across the device, therefore that has been shown over here with this curve. Now, in third operating mode, we are increasing the voltage between anode and cathode. Simultaneously, we are giving the gate also. Once we have connected the gate voltage, and initially the gate current will be low, say zero, then we will increase the gate voltage, say VG1, current voltage is VG1, and current belongs to that is IG1. So what will happen is, the device is supposed to trigger at the value of IG3 gate current. So if we increase gate voltage, the current will increase to IG2, then current will increase to IG3. Once this device will get current of IG3, the device will get triggered. So we have shown the same. Initially, there is no gate current. Then we have increased the gate current to IG1, then to IG2, and then to IG3. Once this device will get gate current of IG3, the device will start conducting and the main current will start flowing through it. And the condition is, first is the gate current that we had given, and second is this voltage, anode to cathode voltage must be greater than breakover voltage. So this anode to cathode voltage, which we have denoted with VA, must be greater than VBO. Effect of gate current. As gate current increases, forward voltage required to turn on the SCR VAK decreases. It means due to large gate current, SCR conducts earlier. We have some important terms deals with this characteristic. So we will see each one of them one by one. So we'll take first two parameters, that is latching current and holding current. If we see this characteristic, there are two things. One is holding current, another one is latching current. Holding current is on the downside and latching current is on upside. What happened is, till our device is at this point, say IH, holding current, if our current, main current, falls below this, device will go into turn off condition. And once we had given gate current of IG3, device has started conducting. That gate current which we have supplied, this gate voltage which we had given across the gate terminal, it doesn't require to give that for always or continuously. Simply this gate voltage has been given only to trigger the device. Now what will happen is, once the device gets triggered, after that, if we remove the gate, still the device will remain in on condition. So the thing is, up to what time or up to what value of current we need to give the gate. So up to this much, we have to give the gate. Once anode current reaches latching current, if we remove the gate, still the device will remain in on condition. So we have two value. One is holding current, another one is latching current. Now let's see the definition. Latching current denoted by IL. This is the minimum anode current required to maintain the thyristor in on state immediately after a thyristor has been turned on and the gate signal has been removed. Second is holding current, IH. It is the minimum anode current required to maintain the thyristor in the on state. Holding current defined for zero gate current. Third is reverse current. What is reverse current? So in operating mode, we have seen the second mode, which is reverse blocking mode. In this, we provide the reverse voltage between anode and cathode. So J1 and J3 is reverse bias, J2 is forward bias. So main current won't flow through the device. Only small current, which is called as leakage current, will flow through the device. So that small current is called as reverse current. Fourth is forward breakover voltage. So in mode 3, when we are given the forward voltage between anode and cathode, and if this voltage has been increased beyond a particular voltage, then junction J2 will also start allowing the flow of carrier across it. So that value of voltage is called as VBO, which is breakover voltage. The last is forward leakage current. What is forward leakage current? So in first mode, we are given the forward voltage between anode and cathode. So what will happen is, J1 and J3 is forward bias, J2 is reverse bias. So what will happen? J1 and J3 will allow the flow of current, J2 won't allow the flow of current. So only small current will flow through this device, and that current will be called as forward leakage current. Next is two transistor analogy of SCR. So we know that this is the structure of SCR. It consists of two transistor PNP, another one is NPN. This is PNP, another one is NPN. This is anode, this is cathode, this is gate. Now, so this is PNP, so here we have drawn PNP. This is NPN, so we have drawn over here NPN. This is transistor T1, say, and this is transistor T2, say. So this is transistor T1, so this is base terminal, so current will be IV1. This is emitter, so current will be IE1. This is collector, so current will be IC1. Here, this is transistor T2, so base current is IV2, collector current is IC2, and emitter current is IE2. Here, anode current will flow, here gate current will flow, here cathode current will flow. Now, at this point, IV1 is equal to IC2. In terms of SCR, we are having anode current, gate current, and cathode current. So, what is IA? IA is equal to alpha 2 IG plus ICB0 1 plus ICB0 2 upon 1 minus alpha 1 plus alpha 2. What is alpha 1 and alpha 2? It is a firing angle for the SCR. Suppose if you remove the gate, that means there is no gate current, then what will happen? In that case, IG is 0. So if we substitute IG in 0 in this equation, then what we are going to get? We are going to get IA is equal to ICB0 1 plus ICB0 2 upon 1 minus alpha 1 plus alpha 2. That means if we are not giving the gate current, main current won't flow or anode current won't flow through the device. So if you want that device should conduct, then it's very essential to give the gate supply. Switching characteristics of SCR. Switching characteristics, or we can say dynamic characteristic, it has been plotted. It is plotted with respect to time. Once we are given the gate voltage, gate current will start flowing, that is IG. Initially, anode to cathode voltage is high. Once the device will conduct due to gate current, the voltage drop between anode and cathode will start reducing. Once the device get triggered or gate current will start flowing, anode current will also start flowing, and after some time it become constant. So this is switching characteristics of SCR. Next is construction of SCR gate characteristic. What is gate characteristic? Gate characteristic is plotted between gate voltage versus gate current. Means if I am giving gate voltage, then what is the effect of that on gate current? So for maximum value of gate voltage, maximum current will be there, gate current will be there. For minimum value of gate voltage, minimum gate current will be there. So device has to operate in this region. Then we can say it will operate safely. Typical gate triggered circuit for SCR. This is very important. This is SCR. This is anode terminal of SCR, this is cathode terminal of SCR, this is gate terminal of SCR. We are giving the supply, DC supply over here, and we have connected a resistance RG. Due to this supply, current IG will flow through the circuit. Let's say VG is the drop across the or voltage across the gate terminal. If we apply Kirchhoff's voltage law in this loop, then we will get Vs is equal to IgRg plus Vg. Same we have written in the first point, Vs is equal to IgRg plus Vg. Vg upon Ig is slope of characteristics. Gate power is Vg into Ig. Rg, which is Vg upon Ig, is slope of the load line. And the last point is maximum gate power. So Pgm is equal to Pg average, average gate power upon F into T on. What is F? Frequency of switching. And what is T on? Turn on time. Next is SCR ratings. So first 4 point, that is latching current, holding current, VBO, that is breakover voltage, and VBR, reverse breakdown voltage. These 4 parameters we have already seen. Now let's see what is dV by dt rating. Basically, a device can operate with a particular applied voltage. If we increase voltage beyond a certain limit, the device will get damaged. So this dV by dt is the rate of increase of applied voltage with respect to time. And it should be with certain limit only. If we increase beyond that, device will get on without gate, but it can damage the device. Next is di by dt. What is di by dt? So it is maximum tolerable rate of rise of current with respect to time. This is the tolerable current that a device can tolerate without damage. Last is surge current. What is surge current? This is non-repetitive current that flow through the SCR. Opto-isolated driving circuits for SCR. This is the circuit diagram of opto-isolated driving circuit of SCR. We are giving voltage. Let's see this in detail. We are giving the voltage at the input. This voltage is fed to, in terms of current, to the diode B1. This diode is LED, light emitting diode. So this will emit the light and hence thyristor T1 will get triggered. Once thyristor T1 will get triggered, current will start flowing through this thyristor T1 and it is given to the gate of thyristor TL. So this device will get, TL will get triggered and hence it will start conducting, or we can say the current will start flowing through this circuit. So this is opto-isolated driving circuits for SCR. We need to trigger thyristor TL or SCR TL. Next is series and parallel operation of SCR. Suppose we have one SCR of rating 1 kV and 5 ampere, and device requirement is of 4 kV and 5 ampere. That means current is same, but voltage is, we need higher. So in that case, to meet this requirement, we will connect 4 SCR in series. So one SCR will provide voltage of 1 kV. So 4 SCR will provide voltage of 4 kV. Whereas they are connected in series, so current is going to remain same. So this is series operation of SCR. What is parallel operation of SCR? So suppose we have one SCR of rating 1 kV and 1 ampere, and device requirement is of 1 kV and 2 ampere. Therefore, current requirement is higher, whereas the voltage is same. So to meet this device requirement, we require two SCR which are connected in parallel. So one SCR will provide a current of 1 ampere, second SCR will provide a current of 1 ampere. So total current is 2 ampere. Next is SCR as a switch. We have one DC circuit, we have an AC circuit. In DC circuit, if we are giving DC supply in this manner to the SCR, SCR will be forward biased. We are going to give the gate supply, device will conduct. If we reverse bias this voltage, device will get off. Or if we apply some force commutation, device will get off. So this is for DC circuit. Similarly, for AC circuit, we provide AC supply between anode and cathode of the SCR. So for positive half cycle, device will get forward bias, it will conduct. And for negative half cycle, device will get reverse bias and it will not conduct or get off. So this is SCR as a switch. In this lesson, we have learned introduction about this subject, SCR, its operating mode, characteristics of SCR, two transistor analogy of SCR, gate drive circuit of SCR, opto-isolator circuit of SCR, series and parallel operation of SCR, SCR as a switch. Thank you.